For pilot Clyde Kawasaki, watching the clips of his plane as it went down off Molokai last month was disturbing. But he says it was also important for him to see it and help him heal. Manolo Morales spoke with Kawasaki today as he looks ahead to flying again. Manolo?
Joe, Kawasaki told me he's 80 to 90% healed, but certain memories come back that are still hard for him to accept. 1 month after the Molokai flight went down, Kawasaki says physically he's fine, although seeing the shots that passenger Ferdinand Puentes took as the plane went down was a little jarring.
When you initially see it, you know, you kind of go, wow, did it really happen that way?
But it's all part of his recovery, along with flying to Kalaupapa with Puentes on Wednesday, where they met with the residents who helped with the rescue.
Got to the ocean, the beach where they brought the, a lot of the people back after they'd been pulled from the water. And I had two lays and threw those into the water.
Kawasaki and seven other passengers survived, but State Health Director Loretta Fuddy died in the water. Kawasaki has not shied away from facing the grim reality of it all. He says he rode shotgun on Wednesday's flight, and the pilot pointed out exactly where Kawasaki's plane went down.
Max said, okay, right there. It's about where you guys hit. And I looked down, and it was just so close yet so far.
So close to the beach and yet so far from safety. He says certain memories still pop out of nowhere, making him uneasy.
You stop in your tracks. And you go, oh, where'd that come from, you know? And that sets off another set of thought processes that kind of like raises some doubt.
Kawasaki says he expects to get medical clearance to fly again in about a month. He's looking forward to it, but with a bit of apprehension. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.